I'm in Birmingham. Not Alabama, but UK. I'm here for a couple more hours. Got here last night. Here for a few more hours. And then I'm outie back to London. So let's see what Birmingham has to offer. We are in Birmingham and we are looking for the boring. I'm literally walking around seeing what's here. I see something that says boring over there, but that doesn't look like a shopping center. It looks more like apartments up there, that thing right there. Actually, it's in the direction of the thing that says boring, so I'm gonna go that way and I'm gonna try not get run over by cars. Please let me look at my map before I get lost. Okay, I'm still on the right track. Let's go, guys. Let's go on this adventure together because we can. No, I need to go down the underpass. You actually wouldn't believe, you guys, I walked all the way around just to come back, well, just to get lost and come back to the entrance that I already know. This is not the entrance I was looking for, and I'm way too hot to continue walking and get lost again. So I'm just gonna try and find it from here somewhere. I just can't believe I did that. Just about made it. I found it and I walked past it. Well, I walked past an entrance of it. That's why I lost my way, but I found it and I'm in Topshop. Yes, I have an obsession with shopping centers. What's your point?
Say hello. Look who I bumped into. Oh, thank you guys so much.
I was minding my own business and I was like,
do you know what? I was so impressed. I thought, no, there's no way.
Really? Oh. Bye. You too.
Look at this guy, yeah. He wants to speed and kill me because he's told people to get to the cinema. Okay, sorry, it's Wednesday, we're going to the cinema. He's told people to get to the cinema for 8 o'clock. He even put it on his Snapchat. It's now 8:30. And this film starts in 5 minutes.
It does, you know. Wow.
What do you have to say for yourself?
I'm sorry.
Olumide.
Ah, you put it out. You know what, I've got to say sorry, innit?
What happened? I literally saw the snap at 10 to 8 and I was like, 8 o'clock? I was like, 10 to 8, you better be on your way. So I sent him a message and he was like, leaving in 5 minutes.
I was just getting ready and I'm doing other stuff at the same time.
Oh, okay.
That's why.
He gave me time to sort out a video anyway, okay, so. Cool. So it's cool.
Movie doesn't start until 8:35 anyway.
Yeah, which is probably about
8:40 something, probably.
8:40, 8:50. Cool though. How's your week been, Ole?
It's been alright, you know, just working. Yeah.
How's work?
Work is alright.
How many people added you on Snapchat? Ole sent me a message saying, Esther, I can't. I was like, what happened? He was like, so many Esther, people added me.
I still got an ad like 5 minutes ago.
I think it's only because you add them back.
Yeah, I do add them back. Because my Snap, let me explain something. So my Snapchat is boring with my normal people. Whoever's normal on my Snap. Yeah, whoever's normal that I know you personally, we're at this YouTube stuff, that's something for you there. Your Snapchats are boring, sorry, isn't it? But no, you know what? I'm team follow back, so if you're going to follow me, I'll follow you back. And I tend to watch snaps because I'm bored, so I'm bored like that. I just like to watch people's snaps. The ads are like, real mad. Oh, I haven't carried that many ads. I usually count. I can't. No.
In the cut. Got you.
Really?
Eh? What's up? What's this all about? What's this all about?
Bella, are you excited?
Am I excited?
We're about to embark on this.
I was just telling Olu about the two lovely girls I met in Topshop in Birmingham. Olu, after that moment, I like went to a corner and I looked, I was positive. I was literally like, oh my god, I can come to Birmingham and people will still recognise me. It was mad. It was actually really, really mad. I'm so grateful. And why was that guy in the lift getting pissed off? Is it your camera?
Which one? The god?
Yeah.
I thought you were just being really
I was here minding my own business.
I thought you were being really fresh and just going.
I hope so. I was minding my own business. You decided to make a comment. Why?
Really?
Really? Of course I'm going to put the camera on your face if you make a comment. Don't make a comment. We've got a friend over there.
How are you doing?
I'm good. Nice to meet you.
We've been waiting long.
Not too long.
What's your name?
Elizabeth.
Hi Elizabeth. Say hi everyone. Elizabeth made it. Woohoo!
So yeah. That's why I literally walked by.
So guys, who did we just see?
Wandeko.
It's Wandeko. And guess what he did?
Black Diamond. He's got a date. You're trying to clock block.
Fuck that. She should. Oh, sorry. No. She should know. You're going out with Wandeko. Are you dumb? Like, obviously, someone's
gonna. No, the date didn't really care. It was him.
He's an idiot.
You're clock blocking him. Like, leave him. Like,
could you imagine?
I'll put
him in the vlog and then his chick will now see and be like, hey, that's where you are. Just Wednesday night, I'd be. So I was like, oh, can we take a picture? He was like, no. You're never going to hear me play your songs.
Really,
really
big
belly.
He's
like,
come really? Like, if I talk to you, I'll show you roll.
Yeah, yeah, he's fat. I don't like you anymore, Wandeko.
You know what?
I was rooting for you.
I like some of his music, I'm not gonna lie, but I'm not a super fan.
I used to like him.
I like him when those more hits.
I even did a shocky for you, how can you?
He did shocky back.
Oh, did he?
Yeah, yeah. Shocky back. He just, your cop blocking at the time, so he was not for it. He had a date, he was trying to get her in, she probably was going, oh no. That's he just pissed off, he's like, come into the cinema, I'm just trying to chat to you here.
I wonder if he actually paid for his movie ticket.
Of course, man. It's Wandeko, bro. It's not that big.
He's Wandeko, like,
it's not that big.
Yeah.
Wandeko, what are you guys talking about? Wandeko is
Afrobeat's big.
Yeah. This is like, who then knew that was Wandeko?
This is Afrobeat's. No, I'm sure because there's black people there. I'm sure they will know that's Wandeko.
But they're not gonna be like, oh my god.
And he's not getting free tickets for that.
So what? He doesn't have any international accolades.
Not as much.
Not on that level.
No. I don't really. See, I rate him, you see, and me, the one person that actually rates you, Wandeko.
No.
You should have just taken a minute out of your goddamn date and taken a picture with me, okay? And his date, if you're watching, next time, you try harder for us, okay? I've met him before as well.
Wandeko?
Yeah, one of the video shoot. Yes, I've been a video girl. Don't ask me which one. And if you comment
in
it,
video.
Yes. If you comment it in the section below, I will delete it. Promise you that.
If they find the video.
Yeah, if they find it, if someone
How many
knows.
Is someone video really going to sit down I'm and not go through tell all the videos?
I'm not saying
I'm actually going
to. I told you guys, I've left my video girl days in the
How
past.
Many have you done?
I've done about 3 music videos.
What artists?
Yeah.
Don't worry before you start going fishing. Don't go fishing. Not allowed.
Yeah, you know I'm not gonna go fishing, but who else?
I know you don't have time. It's okay. Yeah. Don't worry. Come on, and the girl. I'm not telling you guys. And if anybody comments it, I will block you. And I'll delete the comments. Thanks for joining us, Elizabeth.
Thank you for having me.
Is that your house?
It's my best friend's house. Before okay.
You're not going home. No. Why? Best friend, boyfriend.
No, it's female.
Elizabeth is not going home.
At 11 o'clock. 11
it's
o'clock.
It's literally like a
it's
minute
holiday.
To 11.
Tuesday, lucky for you, man.
Fucking hell. Still can't believe we saw Wandeko and he turfed me. Wandeko,
yeah,
I'm
that
not
was so random for him to be in the same
world. I'm gonna go and comment in your Instagram now. I just saw you and you just ignore me. That's not how people behave.
You're actually shocking.
So we've had a really nice chat in the car with Elizabeth.
Thank you so much.
on my knee, and she's off now. Thank you so much. God bless you.
Let's take a selfie.
Oh yeah, let's take a selfie. Come, Ollie, you have to take a selfie with us. Yeah, thinking, yeah. Get out of it.
Listen, let me explain. I'm defending Wendy Cole. Much as I'm not a super fan, I'm defending him. He was trying to call the girl into the cinema. The girl wasn't having it.
She was already in the cinema.
She was outside when the whole conversation started, and he was trying to pull her in, and it just wasn't happening. Mm-hmm. So this is the same time we clocked him. So basically we're trying to cop block. He's trying to sort something out. He's trying to sort that thing out. If it was sorted, he would have said hello to us. I guarantee you. This is not happening.
I think it takes you 2 seconds, innit? Take a picture. Can we take a picture? Chick chick. That's it. It's alright. I don't really care, but I won't listen to your music the same.
Yeah.
Every time I think about you, I won't remember you the same. It's just one of those things that like public figures need to remember. But I get we're all human and shit, but you just hi, take a picture.
You know what? In his defense, he's shocked still. When he's shocked, he's shocked back still. Didn't you see? You're trying to focus on the girl when he's shocked back. Off camera.
Forget.
Off camera. What do you want me to
do? Don't worry.
I won't tell nobody.
Don't worry. Olu, bye. Bye, Olu.
See you later, stuff. Tell me, message me, you know.
What?
The video. I want to know what it is. You're going to make me really go and search and play.
You don't have to, though. That's the thing. That's what I'm saying. Don't worry about it.
How many seconds are you in the video?
Don't worry about it. Damn. Too much. Don't think about it too much.
How long were you in the video for?
Oh my. Good night, Olen.
That's bad. When I find it, I'm going to tag you. What?
How are you going to tag me? Where?
Everything. On Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat. Remember, I have
your name. This is why I'm not telling you.
I'll find it.
You won't find it.
What? Yeah.
Don't worry.
How long ago?
This is years ago. When I was still skinny.
That would have been the moment saver. Okay, don't worry.
Are you sure?
It
would have
been the
moment.
When you recently left.
Okay. Bye, Olu.
Hi.
With Amina today, we're filming a video on
the vlogging queen.
No. Oh my god. I can't remember to hold on to it. We are filming a video on motherhood.
Yes.
Something that you guys have asked me to do before. So we're like, let's just do it.
Aren't we like buff mums? Like, we're just
like
buff
mills.
Mums. Like, right. Oh my gosh. Oh, we're the real mums. Okay. Okay.
Right. Forget Kim K. We've been on this shit for years, okay?
Yes,
she just started, 3 years ago?
Exactly. Exactly. We've been there, alright?
Yeah. So we're at Hoxton Hotel setting up. We're going to film, and you guys are going to see it soon. This hotel's really cute. I've used it before in one of my lookbook videos. Do you remember? Ooh, was that an ab? Oh!
What?
Was that some kind of an ab? I hope so. So I put on Snapchat, I'm craving fried chicken. Because I was really craving fried chicken.
Are we here?
Oh my god, fried chicken. I could cry. Olu, let's go and eat before I collapse of hunger.
Please.
Before I die a death of hunger. You know hunger death? Come and hear the way my stomach was talking in the house. It was saying, fuck you now, mate. Would you feed me? This is the benefit of having chicken sours on your doorstep. Do you know what I was craving yesterday? What? I had a full belly.
What?
Bagel King.
Oh.
We was in South too. Would you look? Look at that. Wait. Hello. Hi. Hello again. I'm amazing.
Good. Just in time.
I know. I start with my personal trainer tomorrow. I am scared. I'm doing it early because I got things to do.
How are you doing?
Thank you. Very good.
Yeah. Can you say you know what you want?
Oh yeah.
What would you like? Hash brown, fries.
Yeah.
Two of them.
Yeah.
Anything to drink?
Nah.
Water. I'll leave that with you then, guys. And I'll take these away.
Thank you. I am actually dying of hunger. I was gonna go to bed with my food. Never sleep on an empty stomach because the devil will feed you in your sleep. And when he feeds you, he's putting things into your life. Part of the crew. You don't want to be part of that crew. Ini Olu. Ini Olu. As Camilla said, Camilla calls him Olu. And Dublin is in officially 1 week time. This time next week we're gonna be in Dubs. That's very exciting.
I am a happy chick. Get it? I am a happy chick. And if you have not been here yet, you need to hurry up and get down to this place and try it out.
If this was like an hour ago, I would have taken it. But now you can see, on a good day, my stomach would be so much more pushed out. I'm doing this controlled diet thing, yeah, because I eat too much. So for like the past 3 weeks, I've been making sure I don't eat unless I'm hungry. Now, calm down. I'm still alive, so I'm not dying. But I'm just trying not to overfeed myself, because I do that. I used to do that. If I was bored, I'd eat. That's not good. That could lead to comfort eating, which makes you put on a lot of weight.
I'm very happy.
You know what? I can walk home right now. That's how big my belly is.
I could walk home. You couldn't. You'd be walking all the way there.
I've walked home from here before.
Long.
At like 2 a.m.
That.
Yeah.
Long.
But this was probably like, what, 3-4 years ago? That's
I walked from here to London Bridge before.
No, I haven't done that.
Yeah. On a nice warm day, just take a stroll to London Bridge. I need
that,
to
fart. That's quite a mission, actually. That's long. That's long.
What, farting? I just farted. I didn't want to do it in your car, Olu.
That's cool, do it.
No, it's done now. Just make sure all the excess is gone. I'm so happy. I'm going to sleep like a baby in a Bollywood movie. Oh God, thank you for the gift of food. It's not good to be hungry, you know. Yeah. Hunger can kill. Never go to bed hungry. I've been doing that for like the past 3 weeks.
You know, I've been doing it for the past week because mom's been away.
Oh, so Olu.
For myself.
Oh, Olu.
And then I've just been lazy, to be honest. Oh, feel pretty
I've said to myself, I'm gonna stop overeating because I just eat. I'm not hungry, but I just wanna be eating.
Eat fruits then, if that's the case. Or drink water.
No, yeah, everyone says drink water, but then you just constantly go pee, and then in the middle of the night, you wake up and you need to pee, and it just disrupts your sleep.
Okay, yeah, fair enough.
But yeah, I'm trying to curb myself just to not eat if I'm not hungry. So today I was hungry. I said, let's go eat some chicken.
Hey, you know I ain't gonna say no to chicken.
Oh yeah, no one says no to chicken.
Never doubt. Esther, take the chicken home, please. I can't.
I don't want the chicken. Because I will take it in like an hour's time and I'll eat it. And that's what I'm trying to stop doing.
Okay, fine.
I'm not going to. I don't need it.
You're not full then.
No, I'm full up. I'm full up. No, I'm full up. I'm definitely full up. And since I started doing this, I feel like the amount that I eat has lessened. I can't eat as much as I used to.
Are your belly shrunk?
I don't know. But trust me, like before, I say before, but this was only maybe about a month ago, I would eat and my stomach would come out to here. Like, it's not cute. Can't be walking around with a stomach like that.
Well, I am right now.
Yeah, but you're a guy. For a girl, come and belly top your stomach out there, like.
Yeah, it's temporary, but.
Yeah.
Toilet, that's what you need to do.
Plus, if not, doesn't come.
Yeah, that's the issue.
You have to wait for it to come before you can use the toilet. <That's> the <issue. laughs> But anyway, yeah, starting my PT tomorrow. You guys are coming with me, duh. And that should be no fun whatsoever. So let's see.
You enjoy it, but you'll feel the pain.
Of course. I'm looking forward to it.
Jeez. You're doing it tomorrow?
Mm-hmm. Tomorrow morning.
Okay, you go. Early afternoon.
When did you start misbehaving like that? I'm having a conversation and you're just faffing about.
There we go.
Oh, good. Yeah, come on. Just a little bit more. Come on, girl. Come on, girl. My camera doesn't like me talking to her like that. Mm. Behave yourself, Joe. There we go. Like to be shouted at.
Nigerian camera.
Rubbish
right there.
Goat.
Nigerian camera right there.
Mm-hmm. All you know is to be shouted at.
What did you call it? Rubbish goat.
That
where
was
did
fun.
I get? I must have got that from you. Did I say that?
Rubbish goat?
Yeah.
Probably. I say goat. I call Abigail a goat. She can behave like a goat sometimes.
Abigail, yeah, this I'm not condoning this.
I call her a goat, she calls me a fish.
Yeah, I say fish as well.
But why would you call someone a fish?
Because that's the two things. Goat, if you goat, I think that they're equal to each other, so
a goat and a fish.
What am I gonna call you? A cow? Cow's really like everyone calls white people use cows.
Yeah, it's cow. Just dead.
Chicken is just chicken.
Chicken
so.
Dead. Fish and goats.
Yeah.
Who's texting me? Nobody.
Nobody.
You know when you wish that one person would text you?
Oh, the one person, yeah.
Obviously, okay. The one person. It's not when I'm sleeping that you text me. When I want to enjoy my Indian sleep, which means a very long sleep.
What's the pillow talk, don't it?
Indian film sleep. As in sleep for long. Do you know Indian films are long? Shouldn't have to explain this.
I don't watch Bollywood, Hollywood.
It's really good.
Only Hollywood.
Bollywood is really good. I'm gonna list some of my favorite Bollywood films here. Some of the ones I've seen. And if you guys have any others that you've watched, tell me because I want to watch them.
Everyone knows my name on YouTube and I tried to change it. I know how to change it.
Everybody now knows you. Don't go on Facebook, anyway, so put the name in there.
No, I told you my Facebook name is different.
Yeah, that's true. We'll probably go and find you on LinkedIn. Has anybody found you on LinkedIn?
Oh, don't give people excuses.
Oh, shit. Address.
My address, no. I'm smart.
Because you know, electoral.
Why are you giving people ideas?
Listen, let me tell you something, yeah. When you first start.
What, 192?
Yeah, listen to me, ladies. When you meet a guy. He says his name is Stephen Harrison.
You Google it.
You need to go on Google. You need to type in.
Listen, guys do it
Stephen
as well, you know.
Harrison.
Okay, guys do it as well.
You need
know?
To check in detail before you even go on Instagram. You need to go on 192.com. This is for people who live in the UK. 192.com. Enter his name. And if he doesn't give you his real name, you must find his real name. Because it's only his government name that will be on 192.com. If he has bought a house, it will tell you where the house is, where it's registered to. There's some things that you need to pay for to get extra access to. But if you really want to, if you know you want to stalk him down, you better go pay for that. Listen, I don't play.
Listen, you lost me.
And then he'll tell you who lives in that building, who used to live in the building. So let's say he lives with family, it will tell you the list the family name who live in the
so
building.
Lie,
from
so
there,
well.
You can go check the gram, you can check his sister, his mother, his father, him, brother, him, niece, him, nephew, him, cousin, him, auntie. Check him. Make sure when you check a guy on Instagram, you're not just checking his profile, you need to check his tagged pictures, bitch. When you check his tagged pictures, you go back on his profile and you see anybody who's in his profile, you check if they're tagged, you check their profile.
Why
you see
wait,
pictures
stop there,
of that
stop
guy
there.
On his friend's
stop
profile.
Stop there. Why do you have to check the friend's profile though?
Because let me tell you something.
Okay.
So let's say I'm seeing somebody here, and then he has a picture on his Instagram at a certain event.
Okay.
If he now puts up a picture of him and his friend, I'll go on the friend's profile. So the friend might be at that same event. So the friend may have put up a group picture.
Mm.
It might be that guy I'm seeing standing next to a chick.
Okay.
So I'm like, okay, so there's a group picture. It's guy. So the guy I'm seeing is standing next to a chick. Who's this chick? Is she tagged? Click. She scroll down. She may have put up a picture of the guy you thought you were seeing about 4 weeks ago.
Wow.
And like me and Bae.
Okay.
Forget the guy's profile. CRB the guy's check, profile probably has nothing. It could be clean. It could look so innocent. You need to check his friends. You need to check any of his friends that may have tagged a picture of him. Check it.
Wow. Okay.
I don't play when it comes to
them CRB
checks. I will CRB you to the
death. You know what? Guys,
do it
to girls as well. So you guys.
Yeah, but then if you're clean, you got nothing to worry about.
Yeah, course,
and if he's
course.
Clean, you ain't got nothing to worry about.
Course.
But there's so you need to check his LinkedIn, bitch. If he says he works at McDonald's and it says KFC on his LinkedIn, you're pissed. He could be lying about something else. Really? He could be lying about something else really? Too.
You know what? My LinkedIn is so pure. There's nothing on it. I need to actually.
If you need idea, if you are seeing somebody, I'm not really sure if you are really seeing him, you need to call me. I'll help you. I'll help you find him. I always tell guys that you can't cheat on me. And it's true. Like, God has blessed me with that talent. You just can't cheat on me.
Good, no.
I would just know. And it might not even, I won't even see anything, I won't even hear anything, but you will give it away. Like, the guy ends up giving it away to me. Like, he'll say something or he'll do something, and in 2 weeks' time, he'll say something else, and I'll be like, hold on a minute, that doesn't make sense.
You see, yeah,
it's always the negatives that always connect for me.
Guys always kind of, guys can't cheat like that. And
some guys just don't know how to do it.
Certain guys do, but there's always a period where you'll slip up.
Yeah.
So.
And that's when you come into my hand, bitch, because then I'm going to deal with your ass. Oh my God. Remember the last guy I was seeing? Like, when everything started to unravel and everything started to make sense, you guys, I was so close to sending him pictures. I knew where he fucking lived. Oh my God. I'm actually a witch. I'm calm, yeah. But when it comes to it, yeah, when it comes to like my love life, don't play with me, because I don't have time for that. And my battery's gonna run out. But I knew where he lived and he didn't know I knew where he lived. I was this close to turning up at his door. I was driving around, I was like, fuck it, let me go to his house. I was this close from con on his door to expose him and his wife, trying to tell me he's not fucking married. I'm a witch, man.
Married.
He was still married. Yeah, but we still see him up to now. We saw him last time. Don't remember. You remember on you. I can't say it. You saw him, you remember, and you were like, he's a dickhead. The only guy you call a prick. You need to be like me. When you're seeing a guy, first 3 months, don't trust anything he says until you finish searching and scoping. Even when you're still seeing him, don't stop searching.
Hold on. The guy that I said is a prick.
Yes, only guy you ever call a prick, Olu, that concerns me.
That he's a, like, he's a pussy, that's basically saying.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Wow. One that's always complaining about you.
Yeah, yeah. Interesting.
But yeah, no, guys, listen, when it comes to me dating a guy, I will be on up your ass like a rocket. Peace. Lesson 101 on stalking your new boyfriend is over. We'll have lesson 102 maybe the next time. Drop your questions in the comment section.
Yeah,
and
I'm gonna
hit you up. Okay, I should start my own little business. It'll be like the UK version of cheaters. She's just a friend.
Jackie.
It's all over, Jackie. Don't cry, don't beg. It's all over.
Okay. I still take the chicken at the back, man.
I don't want the chicken. Bye, Olu. Bye, Olu. Ciao. Ciao now, friend. I'm gonna take the chicken. Bye.
See ya.
Olu gave me the chicken.
Many people has offered me money to show my bae. My bae is one of the richest bae in Africa. I was nobody when I met bae. I have nothing. I have zero cover. Bae made me a millionaire.
Millionaire. Shit. Better hide your boyfriend from me, Mo. You snatch your boyfriend snatcher. Wow, that's him before. That's him after. Really clean and white.
Like, seriously, someone just offered me 300,000 naira that he wants to know my bae.
The what? Offered. Better take the offer. Take the offer.
If you can buy me a jewel garden. 2016 Jewel.
I am done.
I'll tell you who bae is. At least my bae bought me a Burns and he bought me Lexus.
Burns so. And a Lexus. So, it's Tola.
Hello.
She's working from home, so she says.
I am working from home. Go away.
So, yeah. I just received a box full of food from a company called Belefo. And what they do is that they basically provide you with, look at that, it's a mess. They basically provide you with like meal boxes. You can have meals on their own, so you can like order like jollof rice. But I think what's beneficial about what they do is if you order like a meal box, like I've done, and you basically get a week's worth of food for a specific price. So they obviously deliver it to you like this, and you put it in your freezer, and then when you get home from work, you can take it out of the freezer and you can warm it up and you can eat. You have like a choice of different types of like Nigerian meals. Sorry, I didn't mention they're Nigerian. And it's really good. They do meal boxes for one, meal boxes for two. They do party boxes, which obviously means that they cater for parties as well. And it's just a good idea. I was telling Tola, because she works like 9 to 5, so she gets home quite late sometimes, and it will just be quite cool for her just to go into her freezer, take out one of the meals and just warm it up, so you don't have to worry about like, what am I gonna cook? This is, oh my god, this is asaro.
Oh my god.
And dodo and fish. Oh my god. I'm about to jizz my pants. This is, it smells so good. This is white rice, efo, and yeah, white rice and, is that efo?
It looks good as well, like.
With basmati rice. I like basmati rice.
Yeah, I don't like.
I don't like the other bullet rice.
I don't like fat rice, that's what I call it.
There's moi moi in here. Hey, I am ashe. Hey, oh my god, Tala, I'm going to eat today. Jollof rice, dodo, and meat.
Looks good.
It does look really good. Oh yeah. Fried rice and chicken with some dodo in there. Guys, this is, oh my god. It looks really good.
Oh, it's past 12 lunchtime.
And this is, oh, this is beans. Ah, beans and dodo. Oh my god. Oh, it has it here. Stewed beans, fried fish, fried plantain. Store in the freezer upon delivery. Defrost in the fridge for 24 hours before heating and eating. Use by the first.
Just in, what, 2 weeks?
Yeah, but if you put it in the freezer, obviously. Mm-hmm. And the fried rice is used by the first as well. You guys, this is exciting. Tola, are you excited?
Am I eating with you?
This is, stick meat storage. So they've all got expiry dates on the bottom as well, and it tells you what they are. This is actually incredible. And there's one moi moi here. I love moi moi. I like this idea. Food boxes. Do you guys know anyone that does it with food boxes? I can't think of anybody. You get 20% off your meal box if you use that code. I'm also going to put it in the description box, and I will link you directly to the box, this box that I ordered, so you guys can go and have a look at it. Say bye, Tola.
Bye.
So I'm enjoying my first meal. Well, I've enjoyed my first meal. It's nearly finished. This is the jollof rice with dodo, plantain. And the jollof rice, like, it's so flavorful. It's really nice. I'm not like a fan of like soft plantain. I like when plantain is like still quite firm and hard and like yellow, and big up all the hard plantain massive. But this plantain is really nice, like it's really soft, it's so sweet. It's just such a, all of this is just such a really good combo. And the beef as well is tender, it breaks apart like at a good consistency. It's really, really good. This is the first one I've tried so far. So far I'm loving it. I think I'll talk to you guys later.
So guys, my nephew's back. No, where are you going? He's back! He's back from Dubai. He left me.
I'm not giving you.
Go near me. Go near me. Go near me. Eh, go pops. Go pops, pops. Go pops, pops.
When I saw him doing that the other day, I was like, oh lord, it's on now.
It's on?
I'm in the stairs, yeah.
Oh yeah. Where are you going? Look at your bum. Where are you going? Let me move this shoe from here so you can have freedom of...
Freedom of what? Movement.
Movement. You trying to go up the staircase? You like Ekpadoro?
Ipako
Ekpono. Oh, Ipako Ekpono.
Mama used to say, Ipako Ebi, Ipako. Hey guys, so...
We say hi to Tola.
Hiya. This is Tola. Now I have $2 in my life. Remember what I was saying about personal trainer, right? I don't know if you guys can hear that sound, but it just so happens to be heavy rain on the day that we decide to have like a first session consultation type thing. And I'm soaked. Isn't that amazing? Just great. Literally just walking from the house to meet her, I am. So trying to figure out what to do because we kind of plan to do an outside session thing, but that just can't work. The rain is horrendous. I'm gonna catch a cold. Why on this day? Well, now we're just gonna go to her gym because it just hasn't worked out very well for us. The whole outdoors idea. I bet when we get there, we'll stop.
And then the floor will be just horrible. You would just slip.
Look at it. I'm gonna tell them where we are.
The gym group in Ilford.
This was our second option. So wish me luck. It's actually gonna happen unless something else happens, and it doesn't happen. Look at me in my little tidy whiteies, and the rain just beat the life out of me. What does this do?
It offers an outside.
Oh. It's like some maximum security type shit. Look what she's gonna do, she's gonna pinch my fat.
Alright, so just lay your hand down. Right. Just gonna have to warm it up.
What does that do?
It just warms up the fat there, baby, so I can pick it easier without picking the muscles.
It was just this little piece of workout. I can no longer feel my arms. I don't know what I've done. I just thought for some reason this would be fun. I'm so lazy. It's not good to be lazy, guys. Being lazy gets you nowhere. Okay, thank you. Bye. To Tesco to buy like some stuff, mainly bananas before I came as well. I think it's a bit late now, isn't it? I should have had the bananas before the workout. Yeah.
Thank you for shopping at Tesco.
So yeah, that's me. I'm going to sleep and edit. Eat, sleep, edit. Alright guys, so I have another meal here from Belle Four, and I'm having the ayamashe and white rice. It says here, white rice and ayamashe store in the freezer. Basically the same details that it has on all the other ones. And this is the meal. I hope the stew is enough though, because it doesn't really look like much. I'm so excited. Let's go warm it up.